Good morning, my friends. I'm glad all you guys are here to join me this morning. At 5:45 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, there was a magnitude 3.4 earthquake there by Santa Rosa, California. 211 people said they felt this earthquake. USGS gave it an intensity level of 3, which is felt quite noticeably indoors, especially on upper floors of buildings. But many people do not recognize it as an earthquake. Standing automobiles may have rocked during that time. Yeah, it woke a lot of people up. They said it was a short, quick shake. Wasn't really a rolling motion to the earthquake. And using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Yeah, this is an area where they've had some large, moderate-sized earthquakes. 1969, a 5.6. A 5.7. Yeah, they may have changed the location of those earthquakes back then. But you see here, we got a fault zone, which is the Rogers Creek fault zone. And this was a strike slip earthquake. First wave of the earthquake came from the north. There you can see the P. P means the first wave. Yeah, the fault line dipped going south, it looks like. It was a fairly shallow earthquake, about 9.4 kilometers in depth, or about 5 miles, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. Here's an image of some of the felt reports. The farthest looks like it was up by the Sacramento Valley, Roseville, but most of the reports were there near Santa Rosa, Petaluma, Sonoma County, etc. I don't know if you can see this little blip. This is from a borehole there at Santa Rosa, a deep well under the ground for earthquakes. Why they have it set where the microvolts are so high that it doesn't show up is beyond me. And I got another monitor. This is for the Rogers Creek fault zone, and it doesn't even show up there. There might be another small quake here, but because of how they got it set, there's no way you could see these small earthquakes. I suppose they're only interested in registering large earthquakes. They don't care about registering small ones. It could be 4 shocks before they have a big one. On EMSC, one person that was close to the epicenter said it woke them up and it was unsettling. Another one says it was a quick, short shake. Windows rattled. Lying in bed, some art on the walls rattled, and my bed had a good jolt. Kind of a gentle rolling with slight noise. And they're at Runner Park there in California. Woke me up mild, heard some bowls rattling, and felt the bed shake. Let's see, woke us up, rattled the window, shook the bed, and stopped. We live in southwest Santa Rosa. Bed rocked for a few seconds. Short in length, not rolling, more like localized, intense, back and forth shaking. Not that loud as some, you know, past earthquakes. So, did your pets react to this earthquake? How long did it last? Some people said it was only a few seconds. Like I said, it could be a 4 shock for something much larger. You have a 20% chance of that happening. Are you prepared for an earthquake? I hope so. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you for watching, friends. I hope everyone has a great day. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.